Hey, this is Kevin Kitchens, Once Upon a Game, and we are in the Lock and Load Tactical Solo frame of mind here. This is about to start to turn two. We've gone through the administration phase, removed all the markers. Essentially what happened is, if you recall, the AI is playing the British here, who are the defenders, and they ended up passing several times in a row, which made sense as they're defending as my Germans advanced. And then they took full advantage of opportunity fire. I tried to bait them out to trigger the opportunity fire, sacrificing a few units to get others up, because I got this big area here of open terrain that I need to cross, and because I'm going to be exposed no matter what as I start getting out here. So probably should have set up down here and tried to sneak up this way. That might have been better. There's more cover. But the point of this isn't to say, hey, look, let's watch Kevin play an excellent scenario of Lock and Load. It's to say, how does the solo system work? And I'm pleased to say it did work well. A few decisions I had to make, like when to bring the sniper in, where to bring the sniper in, so on and so forth. The opportunity fire is, you know, when the opportunity presents itself, you do you do follow a flowchart for that, and that works pretty well. So the net result is the Brits here are unscathed, and I've got a couple of shaken units, three shaken units here, and I got one dead duck sitting out here in complete open, no cover. This guy can rally. We're going to enter that phase. But first, we'll do the initiative roll. The Brits had the initiative on the first turn, and now you roll for initiative. So the good thing is, even though I played horribly, is that I've got a good setup here of units that are now available as targets for the AI. So we'll get that set up and see how it goes. The British won the initiative handily with a 5-1 roll. And then my one unit here that needed to, where was he? Right there. Who needed to rally also did so handily. And so that's where we are. Deck has been shuffled. Get a new card. No event. From here. All right, nobody's within one on the board. Nobody's within two on the board. So the scenario does not give us onboard mortar or offboard artillery. So we move on down here. So the highest, now we're, because of the way things are set up now, we actually now have some targets. They're out in the open. And hopefully everything's going to work great here. So let's see. Highest firepower AEO, farthest from a shaken. Oh, from a shaken AEO. Now that's interesting. There's no shaken AEOs. So, okay. That was going to be a shaken player unit, but shaken AEO. Interesting selection criteria there. Highest firepower AEO, farthest from the highest firepower player unit. All right, so who's spotted here? Let's see. I think a lot of these guys are now spotted. Okay, these two obviously aren't because they're behind this hedge. And again, in this scenario, the bocage is hedge. All right, these guys are visible. Well, depending on the angle, we'll check that in a minute. Those guys are visible. Those guys are visible. And so they're all visible to somebody. And since we don't have a lot of units here, it's going to be really probably a die roll to see who is what. So, highest firepower player unit. Okay, these two don't count. So this guy's a two. I think it's going to be these twos. Or I guess the weapons will change that. No, that's a two. All right, so these guys become twos. So I wonder if I count the units, count the weapon as being the unit's firepower. I would say so. That's his highest firepower, so we'll go with that. All right, this guy also has an MG-34, so he's a 2. And these guys are both 1s. These guys are shaking, so they're 0s. They're nothing right now until they get better. Until they rally. So we got 3 2s right there, all in a row. A natural 2 and 2 1s with machine gun. So the highest firepower AEO, farthest from the highest firepower player unit. Okay, so this guy is he's got the machine gun, the Vickers. So the Vickers is also 2. And these guys are all the same. And that is a foxhole, so we'll switch that around there. Where am I? Right there. I'll switch that so it's visible. Alright, so yeah. So it's gonna be this guy is the only 2. So of all my highest 2, he is the one that is farthest from the highest power player unit. And we execute a fire order. Alright, so that is the unit that's gonna fire is a multi-man counter with a support weapon. We're firing an MMC. Yes. Let's get this down here. Alright. Does the AEO have a line of sight to a player unit in a spotted hex? He does. So, just like the I'm playing this like the Conflict of Heroes version where the selector, it's kind of like jQuery, the selector which picks the unit that's going to take the action, the terms in that selector don't necessarily mean who they're going to fire at. So, highest firepower AEO, farthest from the highest firepower player unit, doesn't mean he's firing at the highest firepower player unit. May end up being that way, but not necessarily. So we'll see what the flowchart tells us. We'll go back to that. All right. Does the AEO have a line of sight to a player unit in a spotted hex? Yes, he does. He has line of sight right now to these guys. He's got line of sight to this guy. He does not have line of sight to these 2 2s. He's got line of sight to this guy. So if it ends up he's shooting there, he's going to end up hitting one of the highest firepower anyway. But he's also got a chance to eliminate this guy who's actually closer to the target. So let's keep going with our flowchart. So the answer is yes. Do the player units have ordnance? Any player units have ordnance? No. Is there a spotted hex containing player units needed for victory? Is a spotted hex needed for victory? No. So we fire at the closest player units in a spotted hex. Okay. So the closest, clearly, for this guy is this hex. And he is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No. Oh, tired. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, 5. So he's firing at a 3, and he's not moving now, so he doesn't get the bonus for that. So it's a 3 plus the die roll, plus 1 for the leader, who's basically firing with a 4 into that hex. All right. So he's got a 6, and the defender is in a clear hex. And so he has no terrain modifier. We've got a 2. All right, so 6 to 2 is a 4. So we have a potential damage check. All right, so what do we got going here? A morale of 5 and a morale of 6. Let's see who's the leader. So we got a 4. Right, So got a one. One plus the four is under his morale. So this guy's got a five. He rolls. Oh, another one. Oh, and you know what? On the damage check. So hold on. We potentially have two heroes. So the one plus the four is a five, right? And then minus one for the leader, leadership modifier, makes it a four. So he did not get damaged. Okay, little brain damage there. The leader doesn't check for the hero, but the multi-man counter does check for that hero. So we're going to roll this. Roll here. If it's even, we get a hero. And it is even. So hero's going to be generated. All right, so drew a random hero. Alright, and we drew his skill, and he is Rocket Man, which is a hero skill. It took several to actually get a skill that a hero could use, which means he gets a, he's a German, he gets a an RPZ B-54. This unit has fired, and it is now my turn. So we're going to do that. So the range is 5, because it's a reciprocating fire. The range on the bar 34 is, the MG 34 is 2, is a 9, so plenty of room. 2 firepower, plus 1 for the hero, plus 1 for the leader, is 2, 3, 4, and this leader has the deadly skill, which I think gives him another plus one. Alright, so OCD is going to recount it. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Going against this hex, which is a spotted hex now. Give our attack. 6 plus 2 is an 8. Alright, so now here. Plus 2 with a plus 1 for the foxholes is a plus 3. Alright, so we have an 8 on our attack. Got a plus 3 on the defense. There's a 9, so it's totally in this. No hit. So we fired all of these guys. Camera work. Remember, the cameraman should be fired. Alright, so let's draw the AO card. Alright, 12 or greater, have an event. 5 to count. No ones, no twos. Alright, number of activatable AEOs less than the activatable player units, AEO passes. Alright, so we still have 1, 2, 3. Who can activate? Technically, he can activate. So 4. Yeah, 4. And I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so clearly we've got a lot more. So it is less than the player units, so they, I was going to pass. He's machine gun. And he is 4. One, two. Now we need to check line of sight. And our laser pointer is not working very well again. So we'll check line of sight the old-fashioned way. And that looks to me like they do have line of sight. All right, so we will go to our flow chart. It's a chart grab in here. And again, I'm sure people memorize these things, they'll figure it out and not have to keep looking. It's moving player unit part of a stack. No multiple AEO MMC stacked together. No fire at the moving player unit with opportunity fire. All right, so this guy has line of sight. This guy would not. This guy does have line of sight. So he is going to fire with opportunity fire. He has a range of 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So he's going to get a 1. This guy's moving. He's only moved 2 of his points, which is fine. So he gets the shot. All right, so it's a 1. With a plus 1 for him moving. So 2. Got an 8 on the hit. Should have rolled a green. No. Yeah, red. That's perfect. All right, defense. He's definitely going to get a hit because he's an open terrain, so he's a 4. So 8 to 4 is a 4. So now we roll the 2 hit. Oh, it's a 1. Look at that. So 1 plus 4 is less than his morale. So now we determine if we have a hero. Even number hero? Not a hero. Okay, so he had moved 2, so he can move 2 more, and he is going to move. He's going to move this way. Going to get there. So it's 1 across and 1 into the wheat field. All right. So he is done. And he hits a fire marker. And we're on to the AEO. All right, so nothing within 1, nothing within 2, no mortar, no artillery. Shaken AEO, there are no shaken AEOs. AEO closest to the lowest firepower good order unit. The AEO who is closest to the lowest firepower good order unit, do a fire order. AEO closest to the lowest firepower good order unit. All right, so those are my 1s. Here's a 1 in good order. Here's 2 ones in good order here. These guys are still in good order, and there's a 1 in there. Now, if I'm going to count that as that guy with the machine gun as a 2, I should count him as a 2 all the time. So we'll say we got the 1s, and we got this guy. But he's not in line of sight of anybody anymore. So these guys are in line of sight, so the AEO closest is right there. So it's going to be this guy here. He's going to fire. So he's going to execute a fire order. And we'll see what that gets us. Let's draw our the card out of the way. And the fire order table chart. And does AEO have line of sight to a player unit and a spotted hex? Yes. Any player units have ordnance, not that he can see. Oh, wait a minute. Can he see? No, he can't see this one that has ordnance because it's going right down this hex. So that would be a no. So spot a hex containing player unit needed for victory? No. All right, so we're going to fire the closest player unit in a spotted hex. So he is going to fire at this guy. No, he's going to fire at the closest player unit in a spotted hex. This guy's actually spotted, so he can eliminate this guy. He's going to fire at him. That just meant he was going to, that determined that he was the one who was acting. But the closest player unit is actually this guy here. So that's the guy he's going to fire. All right. So he has a 1. And he is firing 1, 2, 3 hexes into the open. All right. So he attacks with a 6. And he is no turning modifier. So it's 4. 6. 2. And roll for damage for morale. It's a 2, it's a 3, plus a 2 is a 5.
And 5 is equal. So it's not effect. Is there equal? No effect. No, with the shaken MMC is no effect. That's correct. Yes. No effect. Okay. So he is fired. All right, so I'm going to move some of these guys around here that are down here. We have an opportunity with this unit having fired to get these guys kind of swooping around, maybe coming from the back way. However, Mr. Sniper is still sitting there covering this area. So I think the first thing to do is to get somebody to maybe draw his fire. So we're going to do that. We're going to activate this unit here, who's just a 164. And I'm going to move him. One, still out of sight. Two, still out of sight. Does he have a shot down? A shot if I go there. I kind of want to draw him out. Okay. All right. So that's 3. And we're going to take a look at our opportunity fire card again. Not our card again. Our card again. All right. Card stack, no. Multiple AO MMCs stacked together, no. Fire at the player unit with opportunity fire. Alright, so the only one that has the shot is this guy, because he's the only one that's left available. So, let him take the shot. So he's under a moved marker. Okay. So he gets to fire. He has 0. He gets 2 dice. There it is. It's a 10 plus a 1 is an 11. And a 6. So he got a 5. So that's good news. Except he's definitely going to take some damage because we're going to get a die roll. We'll get a 1 and get another hero. And we got a 1. Look at that. We got a hero. We do not get a hero. Alright, so it was a 1 plus the 5 is a 6. So he's good order, and good order unit is going to be shaken. And he's going to have to stop. So he's shaken, and he's got a moved unit on him. But the sniper has not fired as well. So there we go. He can't fire, he can't fire. So none of them can fire, they're going to pass, and I can just move the rest of these units. And I'm going to go ahead and just do that, because you don't care about what I'm doing, and we'll set it for the next turn. Okay, so here's what happened. We're about to start turn 3. This leader and squad moved into that building. These two guys took off here, trying to make it to that area. Got a lot of guys out in the open, but they're going to make a break for it. Moved the medic, who was here, up to here. So we could try to rally this guy. And they had already fired. He was stuck. And this guy's sitting here with a machine gun. Hopefully he's going to be able to do some covering there. If we can get them to show their faces or spot them. So that's where we start. However, unfortunately, the British took the initiative again. Turn 3, so the AI is going to go first, and this was for naught, as the medic could not rally that unit either, so he's just still sitting there in the open. So shuffled the deck, did our rally attempts, did our initiative roll, and here we go with first draw. Alright, again, no ones and twos, so we're going to go to counteractions. And counteractions chart. Are there AO units off the map? No. Everybody's on the board now. Good order AO weapon teams. Yes, we do. Fire at the closest player unit in line of sight.
Or change covered arc if no player unit on the site. All right. Well, all units here are 360. So we're just going to fire at the closest player unit in line of sight. And so here's where I guess we have to make a choice as to who is actually going to fire. All good. Order AEO teams, or do we do a random pick? That's a good question. So this guy has a good order, and he has total line of sight on those three guys. Technically, he has line of sight on all of those up there, including the medic. Two shaken units. This unit also has line of sight on the three out there in the field. And sniper. Sniper has line of sight as well into this hex. As well as, no, these guys are hidden because they're not spotted. This guy has line of sight on this guy. This guy. Okay, so they all have line of sight on somebody. So we're just going to, we're going to do a die roll here. I'll get out my desire die here. It's not the right one. Get this guy. So we'll say 1, 2, 3, 4. And that gives me a 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So the sniper's up. So who can he fire on? So he can fire at this hex. This is the better hex because this one has cover. They're not spotted, so they can only fire into that hex. So he has to pick one of those three units. So we'll say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's 2. It's going to fire at the leader. All right. So he fires. It's a range of 3. And no modifiers. So. All right. So he's got a 7. Attack. Yeah. All right. And the leader has a new cover. So it's straight up roll. It's 2, so it's 5. Right, so it's 5. So now his check is going to be 2 plus 5 is a 7. And he is shaken. So that's not good. He doesn't get to contribute. Ooh, that was rough. All right, so the sniper did his deadly duty. All right. So, I think in general, you can see how the AEO does work pretty well after you set up. There's been some discussion on the boards of that's just the nature of the game. And I totally agree. In fact, I've said that. My concerns have always been that people who are expecting a full-blown automated, you know, soup-to-nuts AI might be disappointed. For people who play war games, that was my other concern, is because the few fault starts I had, there was a lot more decisions than I expected, but I think a lot of that was from my ignorance. And I'm happy to say that it was my ignorance. So it does seem to be pretty straightforward as long as you relax, take what it says literally, and expect that, and apply some common sense to the instructions that are on the card. I think you will learn pretty much what the AI posturing is going to be. And sometimes maybe you can game that. Maybe, I don't know. I mean, you determine what you thought. The few times I, you know, would deliberately run up a unit to force the AI to fire when a regular player might, you know, not do that. But again, that's where I guess the common sense comes in of, you know, would he waste his shot or would he wait? No, you know, he's shooting the guy later because he's now spotted.
because he's moving. So I don't want to take this too much further. I think we've had enough card draws through the three rounds to show you what the AEO can do. It's actually a lot more fun than I thought. One of the things that's been actually kind of frustrating me is having this set up on the table, and I was where I could maybe take a turn or two, like during a phone call, but I couldn't record it, and I was committed to recording it. So I just kind of had to stare at it and leave it alone. So I will probably finish this on my own now. So I'm happy to say I'm pleasantly surprised. It actually does play very well, I think. You've seen what the cards do. You've seen in my copies of the flowcharts in action. Most of them. We haven't done an offensive scenario yet. But the net result is, I think this is going to be very successful, especially for fans already of Lock and Load. Those looking for, a full A to Z solo Automa type AI might be a little disappointed, because there's, someone mentioned that there are some scenarios where the units are pre-set up in exact locations, and those might play out a lot better. Given that one choice is taken away, I did find that I had a lot less choices, a lot less required choices to make for the AI once it went through. So I mean, once the game really started, and once the units start far enough away that the AI passed the first turn, pretty much, and then things really started kicking. So very interesting, very positive. After going through it, appreciate you watching this, sticking with me. I just enjoy playing and examining the different systems that get created. And I have to say, this one's pretty cool. Every time I actually play Lock and Load, I enjoy what initially appeared to be the complexity. It's actually the attention to detail is very nice. I do like the system quite a bit. And I think the having a intelligent automated opponent is going to be a thrill to many gamers out there. So I hope you've enjoyed watching this. This is probably a very long video. I hope you've watched throughout it and not screamed again too much at me. I'm not very comfortable at doing how to plays, because I know I do make errors. So this is only in the interest of giving you a taste of what it's like, so you can decide if it's something you want to put on order. But I caution you, if you do want it, get your order in, because Lock and Load Publishing's titles tend to have a tendency to fly off the shelves pretty darn quick. So if you like what you saw, get your order in, and look forward to your comments. I'm sure there'll be plenty. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.